I'm gonna talk about this book called, this book's called, the series is called Narnia, The Chronicles of Narnia. It has 7 books. The Magician's Nephew, The Lion, Witch and Wardrobe, The Horse and His Boy, Prince Caspian, Voyage of the Round Reader, The Silver Chair and The Last Battle, which I've probably left out in here. So Narnia starts with a boy called Diggory, who is later in the story known as Lord Diggory, wears a ring that leads him to Narnia. Not just him, but also Polly, Lady Polly, as she is known later. She also wears the ring, and she goes to Narnia. Not exactly Narnia, but the pass between Narnia and the human world. It's a kind of forest, and it has many pools. So if you wear the green ring and jump into the pool, you go to another place. If you wear the orange ring and jump in the pool, you just get dirty and wet. So you better wear the red green ring in your dreams if you ever get it. So first they go to Chan and do a lot of there, and they meet the villain Jairus, the White Witch. Then they go back to the human world, and Jairus wreaks a havoc. It's total chaos in that time, and she goes to Narnia. They all go to Narnia, including a cabman and his horse, go to Narnia, and from that there goes a coronation, and the cabman and his wife become King Frant and Queen. So I first watched the movie. Then I read the book. The movie has only 3 parts. It has 3 movies. Lion, Witch and Wardrobe, Kalking, and Prince Caspian, and Voyage of the Round Reader. So, and then I read the books. So, but when I read the books after the movie, I feel that the books are even better. Why? Because all the characters were very fixed in my brain, right? So I could imagine like Peter is doing this thing to Caspian, or King Peter is battling with Miraz and those kind of things. So I loved watching the movie first and then reading the books. So how did I come to get the books? They were actually for a higher age group, right? So how I cribbed so much, I'm on the books, I read the books, I read the books, that my mother had to give me the books. And it came by surprise, okay? My mother is that kind only. Surprise mom. I don't know why. So, I think that you should do the order recommended by C.S. Lewis. First, Magician Nephew, then Lion, Witch, Wardrobe, then Horse and His Boy, Prince Caspian, Voyage of the Round Reader, Silver Chair, and Last Battle, and it's all. It has only 7 books. I wish there was one book, not one just, but more, 10 books. That's how I loved it. But it's very exciting when you read it. You get kind of jumpy when after you read Prince Caspian. It shows like in the the description tells that in Voyage of Dawn Trader, Edmund changes to something very unexpected and never quite the same again. So I was so jumpy, what will happen to Edmund? I'm worried about what will happen. That I wanted to ask Google what happened to Edmund in the Voyage of Dawn Trader, but my mother kept it from me. See, that's how my mother is. Now let's forget about my mother and talk about the Edmund plan, yeah? So why I loved Narnia? What is Narnia exactly about? So why I like Narnia is the reason it's magic. It's in Narnia, Peter, Susan, Lucy and Edmund, those are the kids who are in Narnia, go to different places. Like in Castle, now let me give you an example. In Lion, Witch and Wardrobe, they are in a winter, in a forest. In Prince Caspian, they are in a forest again. And Voyage of Dawn Trader, they are in the sea. They go to different places. No, you're right. Actually, Prince Caspian, they are normally on the beach, but in the books they say that they first were in forest and then got to the sea. And what is Narnia exactly about? So, Narnia, the series is not exactly about anything. But it's about Narnia, like the death of Narnia to the life of Narnia. Not exactly that, but the tearing of the copy. I won't tell you what the other thing is, but I couldn't hold my tongue. So, the start goes in, starts. The starting of Narnia is from Magician's Nephew. Let me see it. It's up there. And it ends in the last battle. The Lion, Witch and Wardrobe is about the kids who need to defeat Jadis, the White Witch. She calls herself the Queen of Narnia, but she is actually the enemy of Narnia. So, how they defeat her? Who is Aslan? Aslan is a tiger, by the way. No, not a tiger, pardon me. It's a lion. He's a lion. Oh, very old lion. Like, Narnia has been thriving for 1,001,000,000 years, I'm sure, till Lucy comes there. So, then how did they defeat her? And after that, Horse and His Wife is about a boy called Shasta. I won't tell you his real name. Who is kind of the northern race. He lives in Kalarmen, the southern race. And he needs to escape to go to Narnia. And on the way, he needs to battle wild beasts, fight the desert and the hot sun, needs to sustain the creepy tombs and survive the difficulties of a desert or the color man. So, who does he go with? Because a boy can't go on himself. Right, not exactly. He goes with a horse called Bree. His real name is, the Bree's real name is Prihi, Hini, Huhi, Hihi, Ha. Ha. So, he calls the horse just Bree because it will take forever to tell the name. And if they're, they need to go somewhere quickly, and they don't, won't be. So, Prince Caspian is about a boy called Caspian, and he needs to win a crown of his evil uncle Marius, because Prince Caspian is the rightful king of Narnia, and Telmarine. He's Telmarine and Narnia. So it's like that. So how does he defeat Marius, and what happens? That's what is over. And in Prince Caspian, Peter, Susan, Lucy, and Edmund are there, but in Voyage of the Reader, they ain't there. So in Voyage of the Reader is about a ship called Town Reader, and it's and Prince Caspian with Lucy and Edmund and Eustace, an unwelcome guest at Narnia, go to the end of the world. They need to go to the end of the world for a quest. One of them needs to stay there. So Rippichi the mouse will do something about it. I won't tell you. That's what books are about. So what happens? What are the difficulties? Who is Eustace like? So it's the Voyage of the Dawn Reader is about that. Now, Silver Chair. It's about a prince called Rillian, the son of Caspian. And he needs to be rescued from the underworld. And the nether, or hell, as we call it. So what are the difficulties? How do they resist the enchantment of the Lady of the Green Kettle, and what happens? That's what it's about. The last, but not the least, is the last battle is about a king called Tyrion, and how he needs to settle peace between Kellerman, Narnia, and Tash, and the monkey. So, what happens? And I forgot to say that in Silver Chair and Last Battle, Jill Pole and Eustace are there. So, I forgot to say that. And in Last Battle, what will happen? And that's the book where Narnia is dead. But there's a delightful, exciting secret at the end of the book. I won't tell you the secrets. Secrets are meant to be hidden and seeked in a different way. So that's what it's about. And my favorite characters are High King Peter, Prince King Caspian, as we must now call him, and Aslan. Aslan is the main character. Peter is the main character in 3 books. Caspian is the main character in 2 books. And Aslan is the main character in all books. So I hope you like this video, and I mostly hope you like the book when you buy it. And it's a must read for magic lovers or very jumpy people like me. Jump, and adventurous. So see you. Bye.